to Provo, Utah, Lavelle Edwards Stadium at altitude. Altitude that's been piloted by the likes of Young, McMahon, and Detmer, and home to the BYU Cougars. There's nothing quite like a great rivalry matchup in college football. The bitterness, the intensity, the lifetime of memories that will come as a result of what we're about to see in this one. As we'll see a squad from the Mountain West, the Wyoming Cowboys, taking on a team from the Big 12, the BYU Cougars. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Reese Davis, joined here in the booth, as always, by David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Guys, let's tee this one up. The Cowboys will boot it away to start the game. And he's going to try to return this one. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. So BYU's offense will take the first swing of the game. These rivalry games can really get the blood pumping, and we'll see who can manage their emotions best early.
Everyone's been waiting for this game, right? You know, both of these teams have had this game circled all the way back to the beginning of the offseason, so you got to be able to play under control.
With passion, with energy, with hatred, because it's a rivalry game, but keep your emotions in check and making sure I'm controlling what I can control.
After picking up a couple at 2nd and 8, trying to make that rush think on the draw play here. He'll get it up to about the 32-yard line before he stops, and it'll be first down.
Beautiful play call offensively at the perfect time. In that situation, the defense obviously expecting pass, so they sneak the draw in and gash the defense.
They'll snap this one from the 32. It's first down. He wants to throw. Fires to the wideout. Wide open downfield. Gets away from one, finds room. And he's brought down after a huge completion.
What a beautiful throw and catch on this play. And I love the job the receiver did tracking the ball in the air. Nice job of locating the throw and then hauling it in.
BYU lines up quickly. And I don't think they got it snapped before the play clock ran out. So frustrating to see an offense lose track of the play clock and pick up a penalty like that. The inside handoff. Finds a crease at the 20. And a really nice run and pick up there before the defense avoided disaster and stopped the really big play.
You've got to be loving what you're seeing from your offense here on the opening drive of this game. They're in a really nice rhythm. They've got real good balance going on right now, and they've got the defense on their heels.
And the Cougars will snap it on 1st and 10. Right back to the well. And he's able to shed one tackle and pick up pretty good yardage.
Listen, defense is about energy. It's about passion. It's about physicality. They need a little bit more of that. Get the guy in the ground. You can't let guys break tackles. What could have been set up in a long yardage situation, now it becomes an easier situation because you couldn't get him on the ground.
They'll ride Davis here. They make the tackle just outside the end zone, but it'll be 1st and goal from the 1.
I'm amazed by this offense. This is how you set the tone for a game. Running, throwing on the opening drive, driving it right down the field. You've just run to set yourself up now in 1st and goal. They are feeling it.
On 1st and goal, let's see if BYU can score here. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Cougars.
The offense goes as he goes, so really no surprise on the opening drive. They keep feeding him the football. He shows you all of his ability on that TV.
Lining up for the PAT. And the extra point is good, and it's 7-0. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. On the run from inside his own 5. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. The Cowboys offense will go to work for the first time. Here are our impact players for this game, and it goes beyond executing an assignment to make an impact in the game.
Yeah, obviously we were talking to both coaching staffs this week, and we asked them who needs to step up and play well. They immediately pointed to these guys right here. They are the key for their respective teams.
Yeah, and they don't always show up in the box score, but these are the guys that are the leaders. These are the guys getting everybody organized and have to play well for their team to succeed.
They'll put it in play from the 27, first down. Hand off to the single back. Defense fills those gaps. He's got one to the 28. I know you want to prepare for every game the same way, but there's just something different about rivalry games, Jesse.
It's because, Reese, I think players are aware that games like this define your legacy as a player. Your record in rivalry games is something that people are going to talk about for years and years down the road. You have got to show up and play your best football in games like this.
They've got it to the 49-yard line, and they'll move the chains. And he was able to break one tackle, Jesse, and almost got away from another.
Man, this secondary, this defense, they better pack a lunch. When this guy has the football, you've got to get bodies to him, and you better wrap up those legs and hold on tight. This dude's hard to tackle.
They'll try the run. Picks up the first down, still moving. And the defense finally makes the stop after the sweet run and good gain.
I love when players understand situations and they understand where the first down marker is and they understand where I got to get to. A lot of people you'll see run north-south and try to bounce out wide and make big plays. Sometimes it's not about making big plays. Sometimes it's about getting that first down to make sure I get an extra set of downs instead of trying to make those big touchdown runs.
And runs like that are like body blows in a boxing match. 4, 5, 6 yard gains early turn into 20, 30, 40 yard gains later. They really wear down defenses and they test their physicality.
Halfway there on first down, it's 2nd and 5. Back to pass, it's Svoboda. It's complete on the right side. He steps out of bounds, but he's got a first down on the play.
I'll tell you, QBs and receivers, they practice these out routes all week long. And you've got to anticipate. You've got to be comfortable throwing it before he gets out of his break. And they executed it perfectly right there to pick up that first.
And the Cowboys will line it up on 1st and 10. He's looking to throw it. He's got his man. He's brought down, but there's a flag on the play. Let's see if it stands. Look, you want to make the quarterback feel you. You want to get pressure in his face. That was so close, but just a tad late. Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. And he's sprinting. He'll take it all the way. Touchdown, Mustard and Brown.
And they just keep feeding it to their workhorse back to open this game. Great job in the open field. He's got tremendous vision. He can make people miss. You saw all of that on display here in the opening drive.
getting set for the point after. Right down the boulevard. An impressive 66-yard touchdown drive. And it was capped off with the 8-yard run. And we're all square as he's set to kick it away. And he takes this from inside the 5. Able to find enough room to get it out across the 25. He's brought down at the 26. As they get set to snap it, just about to reach the end of the quarter. Fires to the middle. And it's incomplete. If you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well hang on to the ball.
Well, that's just a great play by the defender and great timing. It was the hit that forced that incompletion.
This should be the last play of the quarter. It'll be a draw. Jukes his way for more. And a short gain on this run, and that'll bring us to the end of the first. Both teams made no secret. They wanted to target their big play receivers, and they've done just that in the first. That first quarter set the standard, and we hope we get a lot more of that here in the second. Let's see if they keep it on the ground here on third down. From the gun, wants to pass. And the pass is intercepted. Trying to take it back. Touchdown, Wyoming. What a great play by the defense, and paying it off with the interception return. The DB saw it. He thought, don't drop it, don't drop it. Then thought, don't get caught, don't get caught. And he didn't. The pick six.
Hey, these guys can play offense, too, now. Look at this. I showed you I can be a wide receiver. Coach might split them out at wide receiver next week after making that big play. But defense, great job making the interception. And you're right, doing something with it. Don't just slide down. Don't be content. Take that thing all the way back, brother.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. They're lining up to kick it off after the pick six, and that defense will come out feeling it. On the move from inside is 5. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes, and they'll stop him at the 16. BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. They go to the draw. He's knocked down in the backfield. He'll lose a couple. That linebacker was a heat-seeking missile, and the heat that he sought was the ball carrier.
Yeah, great job, great feel. Linebackers are making all the calls in the defense and understanding when I need to come through that gap and come through with bad intentions. Those guys are usually 245 pounds of heat-seeking missile.
Finds his man. It's Roberts. And they'll stop him just short of the first down, just inches away from moving the sticks.
Nice completion here to this wide receiver, and you're going to see this receiver line up in different spots all over the field all game long. Defense has got to keep their eye on where this guy is because they know he's a big part of this offense's success.
On third and short, they'll ride the running back here. He'll have the first down as he gets it to the 28-yard line before he stops.
And that's so tough as a defense because they only got to get inches. But I got to find a way to somehow get a knockback, stop the running back's feet. Right there, I couldn't do it. He gets downhill just enough, and he gets the first down.
It's a good job, too, there on third down by the offense because a major statistic in football in terms of winning and losing is how good are you at staying on the field, keeping drives alive. Whether it's third and long or third and inches, you just have to go execute, and they do it. They're trying to run the ball on first down, guys, but just nothing doing up front. Their offensive line got blown up on that play. There was nowhere for that guy to go.
Lost one on that last one. It's second and 11. He's looking to throw. It's complete. Really nice pickup there as they have it out to the 44 with the first down.
Because on a corner route like that, the ball has got to come out quickly. That football is going to travel a long distance. So you got to get it out quick. You got to put enough air under the football so your receiver can locate it. Nice job executing between those two.
Comes out throwing on first down. Ball in the air, intercepted. You're not getting him on the ground, still on his feet. And they'll close in on him after a good return on the interception.
And this is obviously not a great start for this quarterback here. Two interceptions already in this game. He's got to do a much better job with his decision making.
Wyoming has the football back, and here comes the offense. Boy, David, they would love to stack another touchdown on top of that last drive.
And this offense did such a good job on the last drive. Everything in rhythm, moved the ball down the field, didn't make those mistakes, Jesse, and they need to do it again on this one.
Yeah, you're right. They had the defense on their heels. You wonder what sort of communication was going on that sideline. What sort of changes were they able to make? Because they got to stop the bleeding right now.
Picked up 2 yards on that last one. They need 8 on second down. They'll run it on the counter. One step wrap, two step squeeze. This junior knows how to get him on the ground.
And sticking to the run. I tell you what, a lot of teams that are really good are really stubborn, and they continue to run the football even with little success. So this offense is going to continue to focus on running the football. You can tell.
How bold will they be on third down after that last run? He lobs one high down the left side. Touchdown, Wyoming! Made the grab and finished the deal in the end zone. That touchdown puts them up by at least 2 scores. Too early to say it's over? Probably, but boy, it's starting to feel that way.
It might not be over, but you're in trouble, and you better find some answers really, really quickly. This team is putting everything together, and right now you got nothing going. Come on, give me something.
Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point pushes the lead to 14. Quick strike offense on that 3-play scoring drive. And they get it into the end zone on a 36-yard touchdown pass. The kickoff team out there getting set. Here he comes from inside his own 5. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. This is when the pressure can ramp up a little bit on an offense, David, when they start feeling the heat to answer a score.
And I think being down 14, you can kind of feel that way. But, dude, if you put a good drive together, this is a 7-point game. So, Palmer, no need to panic.
I was just going to say, David, I mean, this thing can flip quick. You go down, score, all of a sudden your defense gets a stop, or who knows, better yet, gets a turnover. This game is entirely different.
Looking for a crease, it's Martin. Tripped up at the 25 after picking up 4. We anticipate this one being much tighter than the last time these two met when it was a blowout, David.
And here's the thing, you got an opportunity right now. You got the football early in this game to show you. This is going to be more of the same, Palmer.
Well, we talked to both coaching staffs and players, and they're all very aware of what happened the last time these two teams played. So expect everybody's A game today. Reese, you're right. We expect this one to be a lot tighter.
And they'll bring him down, but not before he picks up the first down. We've made our way to the 2-minute warning, and now they'll try to at least cut a little something off of this lead before the break. BYU coming to the line with 1st and 10. Looking to move it through the air. Got his man downfield. That defense got gassed, but they finally get him to the turf at the 47.
Must be nice for this quarterback knowing he's got this type of athlete playing the tight end position that can work the middle of the field for him. He's a guy who can stretch it vertically as well, but this is a guy the QB will look for early and often in this game.
The Cougars racing to the line in the hurry up. Wants to throw on first down. Finds space on the right. And he was loose and in the open field and on his way. A tremendous pickup on that one.
Well, after that last play, you can see how electrifying this guy is and how special he is after he makes the catch. If I'm on offense, I'm trying to find a lot of ways to get him touches in this game.
And here's the chance to cut into that lead before halftime. First and goal. From the gun, he'll try to throw. He makes a grab. Oh, and he thought he had a chance to house him, but the defense tackles him at the three.
I think really good wide receivers do a good job of making every route kind of look the same. You could tell this looked like a vertical route. So if I'm a DB, I'm bailing, and all of a sudden, he sits that hitch down. Nice job by the wide receiver, creating enough separation to create a positive game.
Trying to bully their way in. And he'll find the end zone. Touchdown, BYU!
And that's a nice drive, a nice physicality, punching it in with the run game. And here's the thing, I like where this offense is going. Nice job creating some momentum, going into the half, cutting down the lead. This thing could get really exciting. Nice job answering the bell right before the half.
On to attempt the try. And the PAT will draw them 1 point closer. So it's an 80-yard drive and close the deal with a 3-yard touchdown run. Kickoff team has the ball teed up and they're about ready to go. He'll start the return inside his 5. Nice job by the kickoff team. Everybody stayed in their lanes and they'll stop him at the 16. Wyoming takes over the football and the Cowboy offense on its way out. Snags it over the middle. And he might be known for run fits, but that was a sure and heavy tackle on the tight end.
I'll tell you, I love the play call on first down here. You're just trying to find an easy completion, and the shortest throw on the field for the quarterback is finding your biggest target, and that's the tight end. Nice job.
Looking to throw, it's Svoboda. He's right on target. He'll be brought down, and that's the final play of the half. That's going to wrap up the first half here, and now we join Kevin with the halftime update.
Fellas, what an environment there today. All the animosity and flat-out hatred that comes with a good old-fashioned rivalry game on display in that first half. And there is no better place to start this halftime than by reviewing how this wideout has been a one-man wrecking crew. The kid's been everywhere. And I love how he's willing to go across the middle, but that he also has the jets to burn these DBs on the deep ball. If this defense wants to actually come back in this one, they better hide his cleats. With that, let's throw it back to the guys to see how this rivalry matchup plays out.
From inside his own 10, let's see what he gets. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Quick touch pass to the receiver. You'll take 4 yards on first down every time, second and 6.
And these little touch passes, man, they're just the easiest completions ever for quarterbacks. Palmer, I bet you would have loved being able to just flip it forward. That counts as to your completion percentage, which is good. And then it's all run after the catch, so pretty easy for a QB.
You wouldn't have been the only All-American in this booth, David, if I were allowed to have push passes when I was playing quarterback. I'll tell you that. It is so hard to defend. It's so hard to seal that edge, especially when this guy's full speed ahead coming around the outside.
Really good job by the defense taking away the deep ball. Remember, you can roll those corners up or you can roll those corners back. You want to take away the deep ball, keep them back deep. You want to take away the shallow stuff, bring them up tight on the line of scrimmage.
Couldn't find his man last time, and that leaves him with a 3rd and 6. Scanning the field, it's Svoboda. Fires left. Makes a connection. They'll keep this drive moving by picking up the first down. They have it at the 36. Simple call, excellent execution, moves the sticks on third down.
These QBs and receivers, man, they run this route in practice thousands of times. So it's nice to see them come out here and execute it in game conditions. Great job with the timing, great job with the depth and the route. Nice work between those two.
That one did not go well. Tackled in the backfield for a loss of six.
What a great job by the backside of the defense staying home. A lot of time the run looks like it's going the other direction. What happens? You start to chase. Nope. These guys stayed home and played their assignment, and that's why they had success.
He's looking for an open man on second down.
That, friends, is a busted play. Incomplete.
Now this offense facing a third and long from their own 30. He's looking downfield to throw. Pocket starts to collapse. And he's going to be stopped just short of the first down. He tried to get it on his own.
Well, this is a really nice job there on that third down, trying to get after this quarterback. And obviously they're not able to make the play in the backfield, but really nice job pursuing. You see the athleticism and the speed they have, how they play as a unit together. Only giving up a little bit of a gain and now setting up fourth down.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. No fair catches here, looking for room. They're able to put a stop to that return right at the 30-yard line. BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. Using his legs, it's Martin. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses four on the carry. So no room to run there, and you wonder after that loss on first down where they turn now.
Yeah, and that's why it's so important for the defense to win these first downs, right? You want to create negative plays to make this offense so much more predictable.
A negative play to open the drive. Let's see what they've got on second and 14. Runs ahead and powers his way for 4 yards out to the 30. BYU right back to the line. On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. Get it out on the screen. Good tackle there to stop him short of the first down, and now they have to make a call.
That's perfectly fine. If I'm a defense, I'm going to give up some yards right there. Play deep, react to shallow. The running back catches the football. I come up. He gets a positive gain, but it doesn't matter because now I won third down and forced him on fourth down.
Looks as if BYU will have to punt it away. First time today we've seen a punter go to work. Not going to risk a return here. He'll make the fair catch. Wyoming has the football back, and here comes the offense. Here's another opportunity, Jesse, to stretch out this lead after punting last time.
I think it goes back to your playmakers, Reese. I think it's finding the guys that have been working for you earlier on in this game and getting them the football.
Yeah, and there's obviously no need to panic. I mean, think about it. You got the lead. You got the football. You got to be smart with the football. Make your plays. Put a good drive together here.
They'll line up right at the 48-yard line on first and 10. Motion trying to get the defense to show his hand. And he dropped it. It looked for all the world like that would be a catch, and he just got too excited.
Well, that's disappointing for the offense because that's a play that you rep all week long in practice. You should be able to hit that one no problem, and the QB receiver couldn't come up with a completion.
The incomplete pass leaves him with second down. Looking for a physical attack from the gun. Didn't get much done on that run. He'll fight his way out and maybe pick up a yard.
What a great play by the linebacker. You talk about filling a hole. Defensive line does their jobs. He comes in the hole and says, sit down, sir.
Now facing a third and long. Looking to throw, it's Svoboda. Almost intercepted, and what a momentum swing that could have been, but they still force a fourth down.
Third and long situations are really hard to convert. The defense knows it's going to be passed. The pass rushers are getting upfield. You're under pressure. You don't have timing. And as a result, now, fourth down.
The Cowboys will try to pin them back with the punt. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. The punt goes out of bounds, and a nice job to get them backed up. I think they'll spot it right around the 15. The BYU offense headed back out to go on the attack. The last time we saw this offense, we had to look quick. It was a three and out, Jesse.
They just had no rhythm in that last drive. So someone's going to have to step up and make a play, David, and get this thing going.
Yeah, let's find some juice. Find your guy. Find those plays that you know you can run inside out, forward, backwards. Get some first downs. Get some positive momentum.
And here on first down, let's see if they keep it on the ground. He's going to pass. The throw to the outside is complete. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
Yeah, when you get that man coverage, most people are taught to have inside leverage. So that out route's there if your QB can put some air on it and throw it outside of the guy. But tight coverage, but a really nice throw on that out route.
They've got a first and 10 as we are inside a minute to play here in the third. Wide receiver coming across in motion. With jet sweep pass. They'll wrestle him down just short of the first down. I don't even think they're going to bring out the chains to measure this one.
Well, in that down and distance, you're probably expecting them to throw it way down the field to get the first. Instead, they go push pass, and they did catch the defense off guard. And even though that was a big explosive play, David, they still didn't have enough yards to get it.
Well, and catch me off guard is relative. That's what you would say the offensive player. I would say, listen, we're playing a little bit deeper because we're not going to give up a first down. We react to the short stuff, and obviously that's a quick, easy pass from the offense. Rally up, make the play, live to fight another down.
After the incompletion on second down, it's third and inches. Grabbed over the middle. It's Green. And he's got enough for a first down. Now to see if they have enough time to snap it again here in the third. Love the way he didn't just run to a spot. He found the cushion in the zone and got himself open for the first down.
Yeah, and you're taught to find that space. Don't run right into a zone defender who's sitting there looking at the quarterback and looking at you. So much creativity with routes now and of being able to just have subtle moves one way, come back the other way. Nice job by the tight end finding that hole in the zone.
Not only is the scoreboard on their side, but so too is time as we open the fourth. Knocked down at the 25-yard line, picked up 10 there, and gets a first down.
That receiver found the open space in the zone coverage, and as a defense, honestly, you just throw your hands up on that because they covered it pretty well. It was just a good play call and really nice execution.
Out of the gun, the give to the back. And he's able to find a little bit of running room before they get him down.
Listen, you got to be able to know what play to call and what hole to go through. Like, the line blocks for a certain hole. Good job getting through the hole, getting what was blocked, getting a nice positive gain, making your situation really good on the next down.
8-yard pickup on first down leaves them with second and short. They go right back to him. Picked up maybe a yard. It's down at the 16. They need 1 yard on third down to keep this one going. This will be the eighth play of the drive. They'll try to pick up the first through the air. He's got it and still on his feet. Couldn't quite nudge it in. Not sure you could get much closer, but it'll be first and goal.
Perfect timing to call that pass play. It's third and short down here in the red zone. Everybody in the stadium expecting you to run the football, and if you don't get it, maybe you kick a field goal, maybe you go for it on fourth. You don't have to worry about that now. Because of the pass completion, it's first and goal.
They move the tight end all over. With the run on first and goal. And he'll take it in. Touchdown, Cougar!
What a day, his third rushing touchdown. And when you got your college fantasy football team going, this guy is racking those points up for you. Cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching.
Lining up to add another. And that extra point was good, and we are deadlocked here in the fourth. So a drive there of 85 yards and finished the deal with the short touchdown run from the two. Coming down the stretch in the fourth, and we are all tied up, about set to kick it away. He'll bring it back from inside his five. Really disciplined job by the coverage unit to get down there and make the stop at the 19. Wyoming takes over the football, and the Cowboy offense on its way out. They'll run the RPO and throw it right. He's running free down the middle. The 20. He's at the 10. Touchdown, Cowboys! And with that one, they jump on top here in the second half.
And how nice is it to have a playmaker like that, that I can get the ball out of my hands, right to him, and say, all right, dude, you got jets, you can fly, catch the slant, make some people miss, outrun some angles, and get all the way to the end zone.
They'll try to add another to their lead. The extra point is good, and now in the fourth, they're up by a touchdown and an extra point. If only it were always this easy for the offensive coordinators. One play, big chunk yardage, put points on the board just like that. On the run from inside his own five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. BYU has it back. The Cougars ready to get into that playbook. How about that last drive? Just carved him up in the air, David.
Yeah, and how about that quarterback? You gave him the ball, and he delivered the goods. Great job taking apart the defense, Jesse, on that last drive.
He really did, David. I mean, that was a masterclass in just reading coverage and being accurate.
With a first down, they'll snap it from the 32. From the gun, they'll try to impose their will. Found a little space, and he's got four to the 35.
And it's just simple. Simple first down run, showing your physicality, setting your offense up in a good spot.
After the productive first down play, it's second and six. Wide out in motion. Touch pass on the jet sweep. He is going nowhere. Stop at the line of scrimmage.
Got to give the defense credit. Watching film, anticipating. They knew that this offense had this play in their back pocket. They knew about the speed of this wide receiver and different ways they were going to try to get him involved. Everybody on defense on the same page, playing together. I love it.
On third and long, he has to throw for it. Going to try to pop one on the screen. And he's not going to get there. The defense stands tall and makes the stop.
Yeah, and I think if I'm a QB, I like the decision. I get it to my running back, who's really good after the catch and really good with the ball in his hands. But the defense did the job. They got him on the ground. They gave up some yards, but they forced the fourth down.
BYU will bring the punt team on the field. This will be the second time they've had to kick it away. He'll call for the fair catch here. Wyoming has the football back, and here comes the offense. A quick strike touchdown up top the last time they had it, just the ball's free. Well, the offense looks as if they fell on the fumble, and they'll keep the ball.
You know, these running backs have to keep 5 points of pressure on the ball, especially against this defense that prides themselves on creating takeaways, and the offense, real lucky they jumped on that.
Second down here, and maybe they've got time to get one more snap off before the two-minute warning. We've reached the two-minute warning, and this offense trying to milk this clock and keep time on their side. Might as well keep pounding that rock at this point in the game, even though it's second and 12. Motion from the offense. They'll run it, trying to drain time off the clock. Good, solid, determined run there. They'll mark him down at the 27. Timeout called there by the defense, desperate to get the ball back and save as much time as possible. This is a big third down. If they can move the chains, they can just about salt this game away. He'll pull it on the read. And they did not let him reach the line to gain. It'll bring up a decision here. Quick timeout called by the defense, stopping the clock to save as much time as possible for their offense. And the Cowboys will punt this one away. He's got it. He's got great speed. Very little will make the crowd hold its breath like a punt return, and he brought them to their feet on that one. Trying to find his man on first down. And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces second down.
My job is to make sure that ball comes loose, and I got to go through that guy, use my shoulder pad, drive my feet, really, really be physical, because if he bobbles it at all, or as soon as his hand gets to the ball, you can tell the difference when that body jerks forward and that ball starts to come loose and pop out.
And he can't connect on the throw. It's incomplete.
Well, I know it hasn't been a tremendous day statistically for this quarterback, but his decision-making has been good enough to win this game. Hasn't thrown a lot of TDs so far, but when things aren't open, he throws it away like on that play right there. He's not putting his team in a bad spot, and that's why they still have a shot to walk out of here with a W.
On third down, he'll try to pick it up through the air. He's got his man across the middle. A quick tackle made, but he's got plenty for the first down.
Man, this quarterback is going to have to be deadly accurate here in this two-minute situation, right? And that's really what he's had to be all game long. He hasn't had a lot of yards because the coverage has just been so tight. He's had to be pinpoint perfect. It's been hard just to find completions, no doubt. That's going to be the same thing here in this two-minute drive.
Pulls it in. It's Martin. And he'll make his way out of bounds after the solid pickoff.
Listen, running backs are not just running backs anymore. You're going to be a wide receiver in today's football, and a great job sneaking out of the backfield, getting them the football, letting them get some positive yards.
Trying to get a rhythm in the passing game, now on second down. The aerial assault continues. They're setting up the screen, and he wisely gets out of bounds. The clock can be the enemy right now, and this offense needs to get some points. Looks as if we have an injury on that last play, and we'll take a break to check him out. In search of that tying touchdown, they've moved the chains a couple of times. It's first and 10 again. He wants to throw. Quick strike complete. And he goes out of bounds after coming up with positive yardage there.
Oh, that just really nice catch by the big tight end. Throwing those mitts up there, catching the football.
Operating in the red zone here on second down. He's looking to throw. Quickly complete. So close to that end zone. He could almost taste it, but it'll be first and goal for this offense.
And the offense here dialed up a really good zone beater. Give credit to the offensive coordinator. He called the right play at the right time.
And guys, if they can make their way into the end zone, we'll have a tie game in the fourth, and the stage will be set for a great into the end zone for a touchdown, and now just 1 point away from a tie.
And great execution. That is how it's done late in the football game. Now, all you need is that extra point. Bring the kicker out there. This is what you do, just like practice. Knock it through the uprights, tie this football game, and we might be looking at overtime soon.
And now a critical extra point attempt here. And he splits the uprights, and we are tied in the fourth. All tied up and just about set to kick it away. And he takes this from inside the five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Wyoming takes over the football and the Cowboy offense on its way out. Out of the gun, the running back has it. And he'll pick up one. It brings up second and nine.
I never know if it's grammatically correct to say a team is being out-physicaled. You hear it a lot in football, though. That's happening in this game. They are just not getting the push they need all game long up front to have any success when they decide to run it.
Didn't get much on first down. It's second and nine. Well, guys, let's play some more. Headed to overtime.
And this just feels right. Both of these teams going back and forth. So, of course, David, this thing needs to get decided in OT.
Let's see who's better. Short amount of time to do it. A couple possessions probably. Maybe one possession each. Who's the better team?
All right, guys. So here we go in overtime. And just to refresh everyone's memory, alternating possessions starting on the opponent's 25.
And it's so nice to be on defense first, just to set the tone, to understand what you need. Try to hold them to a field goal. The offense knows they can do their job to go out and get a win. Just two possessions, Palmer, like you got to be at your best.
Yeah, and I love the new rules too, because in the third overtime possession, it goes to alternating two-point plays back and forth. Who's got anything left in the tank here in OT?
He makes the catch close to the sticks, but he'll be a little short of the first down.
Yeah, and just understanding where you're at on the field, make sure you get those feet down before you get too close to that sideline, so I get credit for that catch. Nice job. Nice pitch. Nice catch.
He wants to pass it on second down. Receiver looks it in. It's complete. He's brought down, but he went backwards after that completion, not the way they had it drawn up.
Well, that receiver's looking at his teammates like, guys, what's up? You're not going to block for me on the screen? Seriously? I mean, I just lost yards on a screenplay. How does that happen?
Let's see what they do on third down. They'll try to get the first through the air. Grab near the sticks. It's Hill. And the defense makes the immediate tackle, but he has enough for the first down.
Well, they pick up the first against zone coverage. I think a big part of this for young quarterbacks out there is if you're going to be throwing into zone coverage, you got to throw on time. You can't stare down receivers because the entire defense has their eyes on you, so you can't telegraph where the ball's going. You've got to hold it to the very last possible second. Try to freeze defenders with your eyes and then throw the ball into open areas of the field, anticipating where your guy's going to be.
So first down didn't exactly go according to plan. Let's see what they can dial up on second down.
Reese, I got him right where I want him, okay? I'm going to throw the football. Now I can get back in shotgun. Let's forget the running game stuff. We're going to play a little pitch and catch and see how good that secondary is.
From the gun, running back gets to give. Pulled down after a gain of five. It's at the 9-yard line.
Man, you play the whole game. Now it's coming down to, what, a couple of plays. It's in overtime. You're starting to move the ball closer to the opponent's end zone. Got to make a play. Got to protect the football. What's your go-to play after watching this whole game develop?
Trying to move the sticks on third down through the air. Touchdown, BYU! And they score first here in overtime. I don't know exactly what the defensive coverage was, but it certainly wasn't part of the plan to leave him that wide open.
Well, I don't think they know what their defensive coverage was either. How do you leave that big guy open down here in the red zone? You know the quarterback loves the big tight ends in this area. Really poor job by the defense.
The all-important extra point would push this lead to 7. And the extra point splits the uprights. They're up 35-28. They know what's in front of them. They have to answer that score with a touchdown. Wasting no time throwing on this drive. And he was looking over the middle and couldn't make the connection.
Yeah, and you could tell he was locked in. And plays are meant to go to certain guys, but sometimes you got to get back, you got to read the defense, and make a different decision if they play the right defense. And right there, that was one of those times.
Let's see what they've got on second down. Dropping back, it's Svoboda. Almost had the huge interception there. Man, what a change that would have been. Instead, we're looking at third down.
All right, well, the quarterback's showing you he is human after all. Finally throws an incompletion, and not just that. After a couple completions back-to-back-to-back, almost throws a pick.
Third down in overtime. They have to keep the drive alive and try to get it in the house. On third down, he drops to throw. He's got it. Touchdown, Cowboys. They got it in the end zone. Now a decision to make with a point after. This is like a baseball pitcher that can't miss. He is just pounding, pounding, pounding the strike zone.
Man, it just gets in the zone, right? When you can't miss, you've seen quarterbacks get like that. No matter what they do, they're on fire. They're hitting the receivers. And listen, that's also on the defense. The defense has to do a better job making him feel uncomfortable, changing what they're doing in coverage so he's a little bit confused. You can't just let him pick you apart.
They need this extra point to send it to double overtime. And the extra point was good as they finished the drive. Here in the second overtime, they'll snap it on first down. They'll ride the running back and leave it with him.
This offensive line better figure out a plan for this D-tackle. He is tough to block with one guy. You might want to start double-teaming him. He's going to be a problem moving forward. You saw all of his ability on that last play.
After picking up a couple, it's second and eight. He's looking to throw. Unloads to the wideout. Almost had the huge interception there. Man, what a change that would have been. Instead, we're looking at third down.
Great coverage, great break on the ball. Had a chance to really make a big play and maybe even take that thing back to the house. But you gotta secure the catch. We like to hit people more than we like to catch balls.
On the run, it's Svoboda looking to the big tight end. He's got an open man. Touchdown, Wyoming! They jump on top here in OT. Let's see, he can block, he can catch, he can run. Yeah, let's just forget about the blocking for now. The catching, the running, the scoring is dangerous.
And they do the dirty work, but this is what they would prefer to do. These guys want to catch touchdown passes. Most of these guys were wide receivers in high school, and they show you why. They'll go up, get that football, make plays for their quarterback.
They got the touchdown. Now in the second overtime, you have to go for two. Trying to power it in. They do not get the two, and now the lead sits at six in double OT. Now on first down, they need to answer with a touchdown. Trying to start the drive with a pass. Touchdown, Cougars! They tied the game, and now they can win it with an extra point. That is what we call in the industry a defensive breakdown. That guy was loose for the big play.
Busted coverage, really, really bad execution. Somebody slips, somebody falls. Nothing about that defensively is something you're looking for, but the offense will take it and get the easy touchdown.
Have to go for two, starting in double overtime, and this one would win the game. Wide receiver shows motion. Touch pass on the jet sweep. They don't get it. A great stop by the defense, and we will play a third overtime. And now it's all two-point conversion attempts from here on out. Try to barge their way in. Tremendous execution to get the two, and now they turn up the heat. Now they'll have to respond with a two of their own. Back to pass, it's Svoboda. Clutch play and execution ties the game again, and we'll play another overtime. So here we go again, and we'll see just how deep that two-point conversion bag really is. He'll take it himself. They're stopped on the two-point try, and we are still tied. They got the stop, now to win it with a two. Trying to surge it in. That's it. That's the ball game. The two-point try gets it done.